These guys use brute force. They're strong.
Too strong.
Then they might be a part of the big three.
What big three?
Androids, aliens, and wizards.
That's not a thing.
That's definitely a thing.
No, it's not. There are no wizards.
Dr. Strange
is a sorcerer.
A sorcerer
is a wizard without a hat.
Our country is vulnerable.
We need new heroes.
Let's get to work.
We're not a team.
Nope.
We're partners.
Co-workers.
We look damn good. Captain America needs my help.
I'm with you to the end of the line.
We got a situation here.
Where's the fight?
Can you move your seat up?
No.
Welcome back, everyone. This is going to be my new Falcon and Winter Soldier trailer video. There's a whole bunch of new footage and Easter eggs, so we'll break it all down. I'll also explain how this connects with what was happening on WandaVision and how it syncs up with the other things that are happening during Marvel Phase 4. If you're brand new to my channel, I'll be doing videos for all the episodes, so be sure to subscribe to get those. Episode 1 is coming next week. But because we will be talking about WandaVision Easter eggs and connections during this, just careful for spoilers for everything that happened on WandaVision if you haven't seen those episodes yet. But obviously, we get an even bigger Doctor Strange moment than it seems like we got on WandaVision, even though there are a lot of Easter eggs for Doctor Strange, especially in the finale of WandaVision. WandaVision was just meant to be a direct prequel to Doctor Strange 2 with the Darkhold, Chaos Magic, and Scarlet Witch, whereas the stuff that Falcon and Winter Soldier is supposed to be setting up is just a little bit different. But amongst the other big name drops that Falcon is giving during this, the thing that they're teasing is the Flag Smashers, the big villain group that they're talking about. In all their fight scenes, he makes this reference about them being way too strong, as if they're weirdly super strong, like they've all been juicing. And in the MCU, you know what that means. So I'll also explain what's going on with a new version of the Super Soldier Serum on the show, and more Weapons Plus program stuff, more new Super Soldiers. But just starting with the WandaVision connections first, so just charting the timeline here, WandaVision takes place 3 weeks after Avengers Endgame, and almost everything on that show from start to finish took place over the span of a single calendar week, even though there were a couple flashbacks to even earlier in the timeline. There were even a couple moments on the series where they referenced calendars with actual dates with that little heart circled around it. For those of you that were wondering about that, they explained the date was supposed to be the day that Vision and Scarlet Witch were planning on moving into their new house that Vision had bought for them before the events of Avengers Infinity War. He bought the house before they were attacked by Thanos, before the Black Order came along, so had Vision not been killed and Scarlet Witch not been snapped, they would have eventually finished building that house and moved into it in that 5-year time jump between Avengers Infinity War and Avengers Endgame. The reason why it's still a foundation on the show when she shows up is because she didn't get the letter and find out about the house till after she got blipped back, so 5 years had gone by. Vision wasn't around to settle documents or just take care of the construction, and the contractors, the people who were actually building the house, also probably got snapped as well. Fun fact though, she still owns that technically as Vision's next of kin, so she flies off, she still owns that piece of dirt, she could always come back and build the house there. But Falcon and Winter Soldier was originally meant to be the first Marvel Disney Plus series to air, so it also takes place right after Avengers Endgame, like within weeks. So everything on that show is happening around the same time everything on WandaVision is happening inside the Hex with Scarlet Witch and Agatha Harkness. And people were asking this during all the WandaVision episodes, like how come the other Avengers who are still alive don't come to the Hex to try and help Scarlet Witch? Per the way that Kevin Feige, Marvel, the Russos, everyone has explained it, the Avengers have sort of temporarily disbanded. Nick Fury, when there's a need for it, will put together a new Avengers team for Avengers 5. So everyone's kind of off doing their own thing right now, and mostly because what happened with Scarlet Witch and the Hex happened so quickly. They also kind of explained this at the beginning of WandaVision 2 when Monica Rambeau gets sucked into the Hex. Because when they walk up there, when Jimmy Woo and her are standing there, they find out from the cops that the magic of the Hex, Scarlet Witch's chaos magic, basically alters people's memories so they just forget that Westview even exists. So nobody has been calling for help or anything like that. They're just starting to find out about it because it's just literally happened in the last day or so. And when Tyler Hayward and S.W.O.R.D. rolled in with White Vision, he actively prevented the information about what was going on with the Hex from leaking out to the general public, hoping that he'd be able to kill Scarlet Witch, frame her for stealing Vision's body, and then use her chaos magic to activate White Vision as his new sentient weapon. Then after that had happened, presumably his plan was to release false information about what really happened in the Hex and just make it seem like she went rogue and turned into a villain, making himself seem like a hero in the eyes of the government and the public. So by the time most of the other Avengers probably found out about what was going on, including Nick Fury, Scarlet Witch had already brought the Hex down and taken off with the Darkhold. It also kind of seems like in that jump forward when we see her in the post-credit scene that she's actively trying to hide herself from other people finding out what she's doing. Like she's in the astral realm studying the Darkhold so that Doctor Strange doesn't immediately sense its presence. But obviously the really cool name drop that Falcon gives, the big three he's talking about, androids, aliens, and wizards, or as Bucky corrects him, sorcerers. A sorcerer is just a wizard without a hat.
A wizard is never late, Frodo Baggins.
In the context of the Falcon and Winter Soldier episodes, he's mostly talking about who they think might be behind the Flag Smashers. So when he's talking about androids, it isn't meant to be like a White Vision reference, just because they wrote the Falcon and Winter Soldier episodes before they finished writing WandaVision, even though it seems like the order's all mixed up now because of the virus delays. Androids is meant to be more of an Ultron reference. He's like the only real big android villain that we've had in the MCU so far. There's always others that we might see in the future, like the Super Adaptoid, and then we have the Iron Man Armor Wars series coming next year, so there'll be a lot of that kind of energy happening in the MCU in the next couple of years. But aliens would be a reference to Thanos and his army mostly, even though there are all kinds of different aliens that have shown up in the Marvel movies. Falcon and Winter Soldier don't really know about the Skrulls yet. Nick Fury seems like he's still keeping them on the DL in present day. They'll get into that during the Secret Invasion series next year, so I'm assuming by the end of Secret Invasion, most of the other Avengers will know what's going on with the Skrulls, if they don't already. The only real evil magic users or sorcerers, as Bucky corrects him, that they would know would probably be Loki, but Loki really isn't a sorcerer, like he doesn't call himself one. So I'm guessing because Falcon is making all these speculations about who's behind the Flag Smashers, they have not yet figured out what's going on with the new version of the Super Soldier Serum that's going around in the Weapons Plus program. But in that other footage, you see the military official giving that speech about how the world is vulnerable, we need new heroes. That's actually part of the US agent Captain America storyline. Like, this is part of a larger scene where they roll him out and unveil him to the public. Like, we need new heroes, and here's one right now, the new Captain America. That's what all this footage of the celebration on the football field is about, the military rolling out their new Captain America. And it's pretty clear that they've juiced him up with a version of the Super Soldier Serum. We know a little bit more about what's going on behind the scenes with Thunderbolt Ross and that part of the Weapons Plus program, but the bigger question, as Falcon's dialogue here implies, if the Flag Smashers have gotten their hands on a version of the Super Soldier Serum as well, where did they get it from, or how are they replicating it? The way they're making it seem, the Flag Smashers are supposed to be the villain, but Baron Zemo is also kind of supposed to be the villain. But if you remember the way WandaVision played with the idea of who the villain is, like Agatha Harkness was kind of the villain of the series, but she wasn't really a straight-up villain. She was more of a Loki-style villain. You do kind of wonder if they're going to do the same thing with Baron Zemo, like where they make him seem like the villain, but he's not really the actual main villain. The way they explain the Super Soldier Serum in the MCU is that when Captain America gets his dose, and then later when Red Skull doses Bucky, those are basically the last times that anybody gets a version of the purest form of the serum. Red Skull and Erskine were the only two people who knew how to make the real version of the serum, and when they died, they basically used up all the formula on Captain America, and then Red Skull used up the rest of his formula on Bucky. But after Erskine was killed and then Captain America was put on ice, the military wanted more super soldiers, so they did everything they could to try and replicate the formula, but it just wound up being diminished derivative versions of that original purest form. That's when Thunderbolt Ross comes along and creates the Weapons Plus program. So the whole idea is they have these derivatives, like you have the version that he winds up giving to Abomination. That's a derivative of the original formula. It's not quite as pure or quite as strong. And that's why with each new iteration of the Weapons Plus program, Thunderbolt Ross tried alternate ways of creating super soldiers. Best example of that is during Incredible Hulk, he explains that he was actually tricking Bruce Banner with his gamma experiments. He was trying to use gamma to create new super soldiers, but he told Banner that it was for something completely different. So the Hulk is kind of a side effect of the Weapons Plus program. The way they explain Weapon X, too, is that eventually what happens with Weapons Plus is that a group splinters off from the main Weapons Plus program and goes to Canada. That's how you wind up with a Canadian super soldier, aka the Wolverine. Deadpool is the exact same thing. He's also part of another splinter program from Weapon X with people trying to create their own super soldiers. So in addition to all the chaos that the Flag Smashers are causing on the series, the real threat is just the super soldier serum being passed around to all the different governments of the world that want their own super soldier programs. We'll see how they play that on the show, but the whole other thing that's going on here is them slowly setting up Thunderbolts in the background and the Iron Man Armor Wars series because War Machine is coming to Falcon and Winter Soldier. We don't know exactly how many episodes he's going to be in, but it's just all leading up to Armor Wars for him. The same way that WandaVision was meant to be a prequel to Doctor Strange 2, but just in terms of the pacing and the timing of that, you have to think about it the way you're thinking about Young Avengers in the background too. So obviously Billy and Tommy, introduced on WandaVision, Wiccan and Speed from the comics, are still little kids, long ways away from being the teenagers that would eventually join a Young Avengers team in the MCU. Probably going to be a good long while before we actually see that Young Avengers project. Same thing is probably going to happen with the Thunderbolts. Like, they'll just start cherry-picking villains like Baron Zemo from different Marvel Disney Plus series and from the movies. Anybody that's not dead is fair game to join the Thunderbolts. And all of you have been asking if Agatha Harkness is going to come back. For sure, 100% I think she's coming back. The way that Catherine Hahn talks about it, though, she says, like, the boilerplate thing, I don't know if Agatha Harkness is coming back. You know, big wink from behind the camera. Everyone post your memes. She was one of the best things about that show. It's just like Loki blowing up after the first couple of movies that he was in. Like, oh, we have to keep bringing this character back. He's just so fantastic. But everybody let me know in the comments. Talking about Thunderbolts, other big future projects, Marvel villains coming back, when do you want them to bring Agatha Harkness back? But what'll happen is there have been a whole bunch of trailers that have dropped the past couple of days, so I'll try to get to all those as fast as possible. The Justice League Snyder Cut is dropping next week, and then the day after that, Falcon and Winter Soldier Episode 1. So my schedule for Falcon and Winter Soldier episodes will be just like my schedule for my WandaVision videos. Almost the exact same thing. Make sure you have alerts enabled for my channel so you don't miss any of those, and leave all your requests for those videos on the comments below if there's anything that you want me to do for those. Everyone, click here for my brand new WandaVision post-credit scene video, and click here for my WandaVision finale video. Thank you so much for watching. Everyone, stay safe, and I'll see you guys tonight.